This is Abby, and she's putting on her new prosthetic arm for the first time. But this isn't a normal prosthetic. This is the most advanced 3D printed prosthetic ever made.
Typical prosthetic devices can cost anywhere from $20,000 to about $80,000. That's a big problem for growing children. You know, children outgrow a prosthetic device every 12 to 14 months.
The global prosthetics and orthotics industry is valued at $6 billion and controlled by a handful of players that have no incentive to lower their prices or change their operating models.
There's been no real structural change in the market for the last 50 years. There's been some technology improvements, but not a systematic change, which I think is really what's needed to, you know, be able to make a significant impact. 40 million amputees worldwide, only 5% of them have access to prosthetic care and technology, and so we got to do better as an industry. And at a limit tomorrow, we hope to be that force.
This is Easton LaChapelle, the CEO of Unlimited Tomorrow.
I use science fairs as an excuse to make something cool every year. I was a kid who loved to tinker and take things apart. I always had a curiosity for how things work and why things work. And when I was 14, I came up with an idea to make a robotic hand controlled using a control glove. I always wanted to go into robotics, but for me, it was always a kind of this far-fetched career, like making robots.
Then one day, Easton met a 7-year-old girl at a science fair whose story would change his life. She had an $80,000 prosthetic arm made with technology less sophisticated than what Easton, a 14-year-old, was developing in his bedroom.
This little girl would soon outgrow this. It was heavy, bulky. It didn't really look human-like. It was extremely expensive. And I just expected better from the world of technology. There's just gotta be something better. And the more I looked into this, there really wasn't.
Easton decided to try to fix this problem and quickly caught the attention of some celebrities interested in making an impact.
I was just about to graduate high school and I got a call from Tony Robbins, and you know, a couple months later we formed the company Unlimited Tomorrow. You know, I wasn't 18 at the time, so I had to wait until I could legally own a company for the deal to go through. Starting a business at 18 was a huge challenge. It wasn't easy to jump straight into the startup environment and to run a business. I didn't feel like I knew what to do. I didn't feel like I had the skill sets. It took so much trial and error and learning from so many different mediums, lots of different books, presentations, and videos, and courses. There's a lot of challenge when you find yourself in this situation. It's extremely motivating, but it is hard.
You know, we can do OTA ourselves. It just turns into like writing custom bootloaders, which you just did.
Easton overcame those initial hurdles and put together a team focused on figuring out how to bring down the cost of manufacturing an advanced prosthetic.
Typical prosthetic devices can cost anywhere from, you know, $20,000 to about $80,000. They vary widely. There is so many different layers of problems. There's a lot of middlemen. There's a lot of insurance billing. It's staggered. A lot of times people have to travel across the states to see a specialist. That's where you end up with an $80,000 device when it doesn't really need to cost that.
To bring down the cost, Unlimited Tomorrow has brought the entire process in-house. They send customers a 3D scanner to scan their residual limb at home. Then they use those scans to create a set of check sockets, which are shipped to the customer for a video evaluation with Unlimited Tomorrow's clinical team to assess comfort and fit. This is repeated until the fit is perfect. Then the team 3D prints, assembles, and tests the device before it's shipped and ready to train.
They can bring clinicians and expertise in-house. Instead of having kind of this distributed model, have remote care, and we could essentially democratize a lot of the system. We could work with more and more people and eventually get up to a global level through this type of distribution and remote fitting process. You know, historically, you could get this kind of robotic advanced hand that had a good finger movement, or you could get this passive device that looked very human-like but didn't move. Truelimb is the world's most affordable prosthetic device on the market. It unlocks a new level of personalization never thought before. We match skin tone exactly. Each device is made unique to the person down to the size, shape, and feel. We pack so many incredible features such as sense of touch, easy to use movement, and it's also extremely lightweight and durable. And we believe that this is setting a foundation for global change within this industry. Up to date, we produce hundreds of Truelimbs. Truelimb is literally a fraction of the cost of traditional prosthetic devices. it's $7,995 for everybody. And for children who outgrow a device, it's about $4,000, half that.
Unlimited Tomorrow's program for children who outgrow their true limb ensures children can grow with their device by sending their true limb back for a new shell and socket fitting process. This keeps prices low for their parents.
I wish you could feel it. It's so different. I have never experienced the sensation of having fingers that move like that on this side of my body. I wonder if I can just... I just got this open. I've never done that in my life, what I just did. I've never done that. I can't even describe to you the sensation. Like, I first put it on, it was like, that felt cool, but when that thing moved and gripped and held that stuff, that was special.
Every time a true limb leaves our door, I feel incredibly humbled and proud of our product and what we've created. We see these videos and pictures and these incredible emails that we get from people who are using these devices that might be able to hold a family member's hand and walk their dog for the first time. You know, little moments like that always stand out to me. We were working with a young girl in Colorado at one point, and you know, she was able to roll down her long sleeve shirts on both sides for the first time. And that really hit me. I never thought about that before. And I think it's those small moments that continue to, you know, just really ignite what I'm doing here.